then maybe, yeah, we were just wondering now, no one, this question didn't come up because here there are big discussions now with the seasonal workers from Romania. But so then Romania is close to Bulgaria, so I don't know. We thought that maybe the question will come up, like if this is a topic in Bulgaria as well, like the situation of Bulgarian workers, or if there are even a lot of workers from Bulgaria in like Western Europe. I don't know, maybe that's what you talked about.
Well, I mentioned this because in total lockdown we were, and at some point there were planes with people, I mean charter planes going from Sofia to London or to Sofia to whatever, I don't know which Western country, but actually it was clear what are the rules for everyone, and somehow nobody flies, but workers are flying. But at some point, these workers are they just the lockdown in Western Europe was such that they had to come home again almost immediately. But they are kept in some, I don't know where. And so there are some misunderstanding. I mean, in general, for this current situation, where it arose from, and how we could actually do something better as a behavioral model, because actually the corona or the SARS-2, it's a behavioral issue we have. There is nothing more clear than this. It comes to us to tell us something, and this is a question that nature is asking us. If we don't care about the question will follow again in some other form. So SARS-1, MERS, whatever, SARS-2, SARS-3, SARS-5, 10, how much we want to have this economy working, and how much do we want to have our lives back? It's very simple actually, but some people are aware of these questions, but I'm not sure that someone is answering, and this is a wake-up call that nobody is answering. And the mantra that I'm hearing, maybe I'm off topic, but the mantra is let's go to back to the normal, but see that there is no normal that we can back to, because we were out of balance. So either we solve the situation in a way that changes our thinking of ourselves and the nature, and as ourselves as nature, or otherwise we will be in the in this circling crisis after crisis on crisis, I don't know. Yeah, so this is the situation that we are, this is our context, and within this context there are importing of workers, flying. Well, the flying is the main problem with with so much emissions. So they, you know that there is a campaign willing to give some support. I mean, economical, financial. I don't know what to the to some of the air companies or operators, and the campaign is asking just to think clearly, should we give them our taxation money because just because they support workers, or should we transform the model and use another model just to survive? And it's a social issue, but it's an environmental issue, but it's a pandemic. It's a very complex crisis just because we are not thinking systematically, and we are we are industrially challenged, in our thinking. maybe I'm off topic, sorry.
It's very interesting, I think.
Yes, also for me, it was very interesting that everyone, like, I think this was the sixth time we did this, and every time when we asked about the relevance for the food system, it was like, yes, we're relevant, but kind of not to that, or like, but we don't want to be relevant for that system, or we are not relevant for the current system. And it was very interesting, like, yeah, to see that this is also the same in Bulgaria. there are some parallel dynamics, even though a lot of things are very different.
Yeah, I think the transitional models, like alternative models of economics, or social economics, or ecological economics, they have a set of problems that are always close enough in each country or culture, because they are very different. They are very simple, actually. If you think, it is very simple to have a garden. I don't want to have a tractor or whatever machinery. I just put seeds in the ground. Yeah, that's it. But many people are not thinking like this.
I have to share a picture with you. It just came to my mind when you talked about this. We can't go back to normality. And it's like, I don't know if you know this, but on the right side where you see the "What if we went forward instead?" there's a local food cooperative. I was just
normal.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But you know, the problem with normal is our need to have some kind of relaxed mood. Let's not worry too much. Let's be comfortable. But being comfortable, it's not developing ourself, our body, our mind, our community. But even in community, when there is a tension between two opinions or ideas, there is some solution emerging. It's a good opportunity when there is tension. It's a holocracy thing. This tension always always leads to something better.
Mm.
Because you're a bit annoyed of something and say, oh, let's try to change this, and some other neighbor, for example, say, okay, let's try to do it. Of course, there are five people against two of you, and then you're motivated again. So I don't know. Mm. Maybe it works, maybe not.
Yeah, nice. Actually, I think also at least last time, but also the times before, a lot of people mentioned this. Now there's tension. There's some crisis going on, but this leads to something better, because at least people are talking a lot about things and they are getting aware of something, and something is changing. And yeah, last week we talked about this ecological reproduced food, and she said that like every crisis in the food system, which like reveals how the current industrial system is not working, is good for alternatives. So it's bad. We would rather not have corona, but at least like it's good for the ecological food marketing thing, and yeah, we will see.
Is there actually a high price difference between conventional food and ecological food in Bulgaria? Like, do you have to pay much more for the ecological
food? Well, double to triple the price.
Also in your cooperative, because there you also mentioned something like that it's the approach is like some social community and not like the capitalist, we want to make money. And usually in like sometimes if you have direct connection to the producer, it's like everyone gives as much as he or she can, something. Or how do you, yeah, it's not always working, of course. And so I was also wondering who is like member from the consumer side. Like, is it like the middle class Bulgarian something, or is it like everyone, or is there some particular group of society?
I think it's a mixed group, but I see that from the statistics of our delivery deliveries, we could see that the number of we have all the information. So we know that some people have much more possibilities or money to buy something, and they do it. But it's not connected like this, because, for example, I'm not like too wealthy because it's not my aim. But I actually, me and my wife are getting all of our food from the food cooperative every week. So we almost are not visiting these big chains. So we try to be a bit against this going to the supermarket and just buying whatever. Just because if we do this, we should invest in our health a lot. And that's a calculation. It's about the choice.
I was actually quite surprised that you have so many German supermarket chains in Bulgaria. Like, I was not aware of that fact.
Yeah.
Crazy.
We don't have Aldi, I think.
You're not missing out on anything.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, but well, the people are they think that this is cool because this is you know, we were in socialism, but in this Soviet socialism, that's part of Germany, was in this type of situation, but not quite, because we are Slavonic nation and more or less, but because we are mixed. So the Russians or the Soviets back in these days, they try to influence the here, specifically on the Balkans, very, very brutal. So people are people became consumers. They didn't know what consumer is, and then they suddenly became consumers, and they have something to like a free will, and they are ruling the invisible hand of the market. So they at some point are in capitalism, and they are free to choose whatever they are willing, not what they need, but actually what they the desires are. So they focus on the desires, and then of course this comes with some price. For example, health or psychics. I don't know. No, psychology, psychological problems. Yeah, because in this situation in Bulgaria, transiting for many years from this model of not so communism, but more like Soviet socialism, made the people unaware of being able to influence. And I mean, also in voting, people say, these which are in power, they will stay in power. I'm not part of the equation, and that's a problem. And this is how we, 30 or 40 years after that, maybe 70 years after that, we will meet also this problem of lack of emancipation or empowerment of local people.
Do you think that like the younger generations are now starting to realize that they do play a role in the political system, for example, because like technically they haven't experienced the Soviet system themselves, right?
Some of young people, some of the young people, of course, are well aware of the pluses and the minuses of the socialist systems in general and specifically in Bulgaria, maybe. But this is something that is not learned in school. So the period from the World War II to nowadays, actually, it's a blank spot in Bulgarian history, and nobody's actually doing anything to do something about it. So we have some homework that we haven't prepared. So this is how the consumer thinking is not developing well, because actually there are lazy governmental structures, lazy consumers, lazy many people, because maybe it is the weather, maybe maybe it's something else, but in general it is in here it is in general very, very slowly. I mean, like we are in slow motion from point of view of Northern Europe, for example. As a, if you come here to make business, you will be on normal speed for yourselves, but here the speed will be double as a contrast to the others. I'm not saying that everyone is so phlegmatic, but in general, this is a cultural oriental thing. Actually, it comes from the Orient, and we most of us are not aware of the Orient within them, but actually having this name Asen, which is a cousin with the Hassan, so I think that we should be more aware of our Oriental part.
Well, I'm also not sure. Sometimes I feel like changes in Germany, for example, as well are more than slow, or sometimes not taking part, when you think there could have been happening so much things until now. But well, since 30 years, it's like, oh yeah, there is climate change. We have to do things sometimes, not yet, later on. We will do it in 5 years. Oh, we didn't. Mm-hmm. We will do it in the next 5 years.
Carsten and Claudi, do you still have any questions? Okay, you're just listening. That's good.
No, I don't have any questions. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, makes sense to turn the microphone on. No, no questions at all. And it was very interesting to see, yeah, how much parallels are in Bulgaria and Germany and wherever it's, yeah. Again, the problem is the system, because it's a lot about the capitalism and making money and don't caring about the health of people. Yeah. Yes, thanks a lot.